Peggy 16.
I have been around since before we ever launched the game back in 2002, and I've probably had my finger in almost every single zone in the game. But Praetoria is bar none the most beautiful, comprehensive landscape that we have ever put into the game.
Going Rogue is the best-looking City of Heroes ever. I don't think it's an overstatement to say that it's a complete reinvention of the game, and that graphically we have more realism and polish than we've ever achieved before.
It was built from an art perspective with the graphical update in mind. Everything is just 300 times more vibrant.
The environment team has really outdone itself in making literally every block feel unique. You're never going to go from block A to block B and feel like, hey, I've been there already.
When we first started showing screenshots of everything that Ultra Mode had on it, you know, a lot of people were like, that's not our game. That can't be City of Heroes. That looks way too good to be City of Heroes.
Thanks to Ultra Mode, we have real-time shadows. What that means is as the sun moves across the sky, as the day turns to night, you'll actually see every object in the game casting a shadow on the ground, and you can actually watch it move if you look that closely. So now everything feels more rooted and more real.
The whole idea behind Praetoria is that it's a utopian society, so it's a very beautiful world. It's the very highly polished gold veneer on top of the sort of corrupt iron fist.
It's an alternate dimension, an alternate Earth, as it were. It's a world where good and evil are sort of reversed.
Praetoria offers four brand new zones. The first one is Nova Praetoria. This is the seat of government. Everything is gold windows and reflectivity and just beauty.
It's the common area for all new characters, very similar to the Atlas Plaza in Atlas Park.
Then you cross the bridge and you get into Imperial City. This is a finance sector, a business sector, skyscrapers, just verticality. Then you move across to the next island, Neutropolis, and that's sort of a science city ruled by Neuron and sort of looking in a rival way over to Tyrant's Tower on the other side of the zone. And the fourth zone is the underground.
The underground is a series of tunnels underneath every single Praetorian city zone.
This is sort of the sewer network that the Resistance lives in.
City of Heroes Going Rogue pretty much reinvents the franchise.
There's new story arcs, there's new experience of creating a brand new character.
We give you new missions, new zones, but we've also had a huge graphical upgrade.
The Going Rogue alignment system is unique unto itself. I don't think any other MMO does this.
Players take any single character and experience all the content that's in the entire game. We want to make sure that their heroes feel that they're out there saving the world on a daily basis. Getting players to invest themselves is, you know, the goal of any MMO, and I think we do it better than anyone else.